Hello friends, welcome back to I Made Me Think. Welcome to this exciting video series tutorial, Cucumber tutorial for BDD with Java. So the agenda is, what is Cucumber, what is Gherkin, and all those points we will cover in subsequent videos. So let's get started. So what is Cucumber? It is a trusting framework which is used in behavior driven development based testing. Using Cucumber, we can define application behavior in plain English text. It uses Gherkin language. So next question is, what is Gherkin? Gherkin is the language that Cucumber understands. It is a business readable domain specific language that lets you describe software's behavior without detailing how that behavior is implemented. Gherkin serves two purposes: documentation and automated tests. So what are the keywords used in Cucumber? So these are the typical keywords used: given, when, and, then, but, scenario, scenario outline, background, examples, example table, feature. We will see a couple of examples which will explain all these keywords. So first, let us understand what is a feature file. A file with .feature extension, a place where user can write different scenarios, Gherkin plain English statements in short called as steps. Example, we will see an example and I will explain a sample project. The sample project link is available in the comment section and it is also available in my GitHub repository. So what is step, step definition and step implementation? So before that, let us see the sample project. So here is a sample project underscore cucumber, and this is the sample project structure. So if you see, there are different source folders. So in src test resources, I have a couple of feature files. So by the way, this is a Maven based project. So typically, for a Maven based project, we will have pom.xml. So I will explain this little detail. So first, let us see what is a feature. So what is a feature? Brief summary about feature, short description about particular feature. So whenever a feature file is written, it should start with the word called feature, and we should have some title and some explanation. So that is why brief is brief summary and short description. Then we have something called background. So background acts as a precondition for every test scenario. So in background, we have a couple of steps given, web application is running, and more precondition for each test scenario. So secure login with capture functionality is implemented. So this example is kind of a real example where we see a typical web application is running, and so currently the feature is secure login with capture is implemented. So what is a scenario? So brief summary about this particular test scenario is called scenario. So the headline is secure login using desktop website. Precondition for this scenario: given on desktop browser on home page, login button and captcha is available. Additional precondition: and. So when we start a feature file, it should start with feature. We can have something called background. So background steps will run for each and every test scenario. This is optional. And then we have to explain individual scenario here. So the statement we should write is, it should typically start with given and when and then. And we can have this additional preconditions, for example, using and. And there's also something called but. So we will come to this. So precondition, additional precondition, individual step. So for a normal test case or for a normal scenario, this number of steps may vary. So as of now, I have one step written as using when and additional individual step performed by users. So I have two steps. So likewise, I can go for when and when I do this and I do this and I do this, then expected scenario behavior. So it should start with then. Additional expected test scenario, that should start with and. But following behavior is not expected. So in a test case, when we perform certain steps, we expect something and we don't expect something. So whatever we expect, that comes under then and, and whatever we don't expect, that typically should be written as but. Now let's understand some simple concept. So we have something called master runner for this particular feature file. So I will come to this when I run this program. For now, just ignore other feature files. So let's consider only one feature file is there, and we have one runner file which is for Maven based project, and we have something called step definition and step implementation. So as of now, let's go back and see what is step definition and step implementation. Step, smallest individual action by user written in Gherkin. Step definition, actual testing implementation for each step, that is actual automation code pertaining to each step, usually a call to a method in Java. Step implementation, so detailed automation code with many small piece of code to achieve particular functionality, and that's what we will see an example. So now we have seen basic of a feature file. Now let's go and see what is step definition. So for a normal user, or for a non-technical person, or anybody who wants to understand, he can just look at this particular steps and he can understand what's going on with the BDD based testing approach. But then the actual automation person need to implement this, so need to actually define this step. What does this mean in terms of Java? So typically it's a, let's say web application is running, so launch some web application in backend, run some batch files or some server. So in step definition, we will interpret the particular given Gherkin statement in a method call, and from there onwards our actual automation starts. So there are different cases. So we have given, when, so all these are steps, given and whatever is with these keywords is marked, all these are steps. So we need to do a step definition. So we need to define what does that mean in terms of Java. So these are the steps, basically a Java method call. So if you see, these are all method calls for particular step, and then this is the annotation we need to use. This is a Cucumber annotation. So if you see the annotation here, so Cucumber API given, then, when, all these annotations we have to use. And this is again some simple Java concept. So I'm making a handle here, and I'm doing a step implementation here. So step implementation. So in step implementation, what is step implementation? Detailed automation code with many small piece of code to achieve particular functionality. So a step definition will just have a method call, and a step implementation, in the step implementation we'll have a detailed implementation of that particular step. It might need to call some couple of other methods, or there are some dependency and many more. So as of now, I have put it as simple step implementations. I'm just printing a sys out with that step name itself. So the purpose of this video is to introduce Cucumber and not in detail about how to implement the steps. Okay. Parameterization. So before this, just let us run the program and see what is the output. So this is a Maven program, this is a Maven project, and if you see, this is a .pom file, pom.xml, and it has all the dependency details. So typically the dependency what we have is Cucumber-Java, and this is the version I'm using currently. This may not be the latest, but this solves the purpose as of now. And at the end, we will see what is called master runner, runner file, how to link it and how to use it. So let's run this simple program, say the Maven based. Typically Maven based program will take a little more time to build and compile, so there are different profiles, different levels of compilation and running steps in Maven, so it will take a little more time. For the first time it takes time, then second time onwards it will not take much time. Okay, so now for each particular step there is a step definition, and then that step definition is also implemented using step implementation. So feature file, step definition and step implementation, so these are the basically the implementation. So as of now what I have done is I have just put some sysout statements just to understand basically what it does and how it does. Now we don't need this delay, so let's not have this delay as of now. Again going back, so parameterization, so we have seen that we can write certain English statements and then we can convert it into a Java method call and then we can take it forward for our actual automation. So what if we want to pass some parameters? So there are different ways how can we pass parameters to the actual Java code. We can pass integer, string, whatever we want, and we can pass out a list of parameters. We can pass something called data table, so how to receive it or how to capture it. There are a couple of other things, so we will see that. So let's see what is this. So this is an example for parameterization. So let's see parameter passing. So passing integer with value 100, passing a string, passing a boolean, passing a float, and multiple parameter passing. This is in this method or in this way of passing parameter we can pass a table. So this is something called data table, which is for a particular step. So let's see another example here. So we have something called scenario outline. So this is similar to scenario, but the thing is in scenario, in this particular feature file, so this is one scenario. So what it will do is it will just execute all the steps once and that's it. Now what if you want to run all these steps for say number of users or for number of browsers or for number of variable parameters? So we have something called scenario outline, in which we have something called examples. So whatever number of rows are here, so these many number of steps will be repeated for number of rows which are present in examples. So in that way we can optimize more scenarios in a short way, so that our automation the feature file looks very simple. So what we are doing is we are passing two different parameters, so device type and app version, and repeating all those steps for number of rows here. Now let's see a simple step definition. So for this particular statement, given statement, let's go to the declaration. So in this way we can have a Java implementation or the Java code for particular step. Now let's see for scenario outline. So for scenario outline is also more or less the same. It depends on how do we define this parameter and what is the heading here. Now the main thing what I wanted to show here is how to capture the integer and different type of variables. So when we capture an integer, we can capture it using this particular way, or we have something called dot plus. So dot plus is capture any item, int, float, double, string or boolean. So if we are not sure what value we are getting from the cucumber scenarios, then we can definitely go for this dot plus. But as of now, when we know that it is an integer, so we can go for this string. So for string we can use this particular structure, or otherwise we can again go for this dot plus, which will capture any item, so integer, float or double. Then boolean, so for boolean we know there are gonna be only two values, true or false, so we have to go via this like this, we have to capture it. And then float or non-integer value, so again we can go for like this dot this, so basically integer part and real part, two different part, or so floating integer part and floating rate part, we can go via this, or we can just declare it using float. And this is something called data table. So data table is a simple table which is specific to any particular step and which is not for a current scenario outline. So normally it is confusing that what is the difference between scenario outline and this particular data table. So here also we are passing a kind of a table, here also we are passing a kind of a table, but in this case scenario outline case, it is these parameters are for the entire scenario. So in any step we can just refer this device type here also, just for an example. So these are the parameters which are available for any particular step, and this when we say scenario outline, it will run for number of rows in the examples. But what happens in non-scenario outline? So in this case, these are the steps which will not run for these many times, but for this particular step these are the parameters which are passed, and they will be directly passed as a data table. So we will see the implementation of data table. So to run this example, I have to make some change. So these, what are these changes? This also we will see as a part of next presentation. So scenario outline here. So now we need to see 1, 2, 3. So this scenario will be executed 3 times and then parameter passing. Now if you see, so once, so this is for secure login with device type. So first it should be Android, Apple and BlackBerry. So 3 times, so this scenario outline, so this repeated 3 times itself, and then this is for this particular scenario. So passing parameters, as if you see, we have passed an integer, captured it, string captured, boolean captured, float or double I have captured, and then data table. So data table, again whatever we have passed here, this data table is part of this particular step. So data table option, I have validated it here. So let's see the implementation of this. So how the data capturing is done. So data capture, we have to take it as raw in a list of string, and then just do a get and get. So get row and column index, and we will get that value. So point to remember here is this particular first row will be 0, so this will be 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1 2 0 2 1 3 0 3 1 and so on. So parameterization we have seen. So automatically generate step definition code. So typically what happens is in a normal automation activity, we get some scenarios, we write some scenarios, and then by some mistake, or typically we don't implement any particular step. So what Cucumber does is, so now this is an example feature file 3 in which I have this particular step which is not implemented. So the step definition for this is missing. So if you see, the warning symbol has come that there is no step definition. So for to run this feature file 3, again I have to make one change here, which I will explain in some time. So basically I am considering here the feature file 3, this particular, and I am running it again. So far, if you see this output earlier, nowhere it has mentioned that a particular step is not implemented, because all the steps are implemented here. Now the thing is, when we are running this file number 3, which has all the steps implemented except this. So now let's see what happens. So all these steps are implemented except step without step definition. Now let's see what happens. If you see, for all these steps, I have written a sysout. So we got some sysout here, like step with this so and so, but it has also given a print that you can implement missing step with the snippet below. So step without step definition, step without step definition. So the thing is, for all these steps, the definition is part is present, but for this particular step, the definition part is not there. So what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to copy this and go to step definition, and somewhere I just put this, and for now just forget about it. Now you see the step definition for this particular step is available now. So now if I run this program, I will not get these prints that you can implement. So the advantage here is Cucumber automatically generate the Java code to for a particular step which is not implemented. So coming to this Maven dependency and Java jar file. So in this repository, in Maven repository, just search for Cucumber Java or just Google it, and then in this repository, the latest files, the latest version. So for Maven based project, we can add this dependency, which I have already added, and for non Maven based project, we can just download this jar, add it as a dependency, add it as a external jar in your Eclipse project or wherever you want, and you can continue with the steps. So as of now, since this is a Maven based project, so I will not be doing it. I'll just going it for Maven dependency in POM file. So if you see here, I have already included it, the same dependency here. I'm just using the 1.2.2 version. So now, before finishing this session, just we will understand what is a runner file. So in Maven based project, where we are using Cucumber and Java and BDD, we need something called runner file, which will actually run the Cucumber scenarios and then we'll convert it into the step definition and so on and so forth. So here we have something called runner file, which I need to mention in the POM file. If you come down, you see this runner file is mentioned here. So what happens is, when Maven takes the control, it basically looks for which Java file I need to run, the Maven has to run, and then it will open this Java file, the runner file, and then it will start just passing. So as of now, what I have done is we have some annotations called run with and cucumber options, so which I will cover in the next PPT, in the next session. But just try to understand that this class will be run as JUnit, and it will be running using this run with annotation, and it will basically run with cucumber class, which will take control and so on. So these are the cucumber options we will see in this detail and how it runs. So for more exciting videos, please like, comment and share my video channel. Thanks for watching.